What is a grading plan in construction? I haven't covered this topic for a long time, and I'm excited to do it now because before I talked about the technical aspects, now I'm going to talk to you about the mindset. If you're into that, stay with us. I'm super excited about this because this is so important to me. Like you hear in the book, The Art of War by Sun Tzu or Master Sun, about terrain. You hear about war stories about how important logistics are. And in construction, I hear these generals when I'm interviewing them, general superintendents and field directors, talking to me about logistics. In fact, it was 2 years ago where a really renowned stadium builder was talking to me about the importance of logistics. And that's where we got the logistics rules and the full checklist and the whole nine. I'm really excited about it. So let's talk about the grading plan and answer some questions. What exactly is shown on a grading plan? Well, you know the technical stuff. I've covered that before. But on the grading plan, obviously you'll see elevations. You will see slopes. You'll see the structures on the site. And you'll see exactly what needs to be done to the site before you can actually go vertically or horizontally, meaning with the infrastructure, on your site. Expect to see dimensions, coordinates. You better see coordinates or I'm gonna be super frustrated. Distances and bearings, like I said, elevations previously, and how the site is designed. How does grading impact the construction schedule? Well, two things. You're gonna have to have, in most cities, a grading and drainage plan and permit before you can get the building permit. So it's super critical from a permitting standpoint. The other thing is, typically when you're looking at a production plan, you've got your mobilization and make ready, then foundations, then superstructure, then your interiors. I'm telling you, the two areas where I always end up helping companies pick up time is in the interiors, the roughing and the finishes, the exteriors, and then early on in the clearing and the grading and the drainage plan, meaning your site grading and your site work before you start your foundations. And I'll tell you why. Because how you zone this is crucial to how fast you're able to start something else. And so it's critical that you zone it properly, that you zone it in the right sequence, which nowadays I'm actually using AI to help me, so you can start your first building and your foundations right away. It's absolutely phenomenal, okay? So it is crucial to your construction schedule from those two standpoints. Number three, what can happen if you don't follow your grading plan? Let me tell you, all the way from too much dust in the desert to not having access out in Virginia because you don't have the right stabilization and it rains so much, to being up north, having the site literally freeze and you not being able to do work or place concrete. I have seen this effect so much. The other thing is, and I was going to cover this later, but I'll cover it now, is how you prepare the soil is how your building is going to go. I've seen settling. Again, I've seen freezing. I've seen weather and improper drainage affect the concrete placement. It has a massive impact on everything you do on your project site. So it is so important. So let me just describe what winning looks like. I want the site graded in the right segment. Unless the city makes you do it, you don't have to do the whole site. Do it phase by phase. But go ahead and get it prepared, stabilized with your storm water pollution prevention best management practices in place. I want to see drainage. I don't want the footings being filled with water. I want dewatering done. I want good stabilization. If you can stabilize that site or even get paving up to the buildings right away, do it 100%. And I want those building pads so well compacted that they're not going to settle, that you have a good pad certification, good elevations, and you're able to really go in there and, whether it's caissons or you have spot footings and continuous footings, cut in your footings and really get those foundations going in a remarkable way without too much impact. The other thing is, I don't want to be doing the interiors with tracking mud around everywhere. Prepare the site. Pretend that the buildings are your customer and that you want to provide the most remarkable environment. Logistics, logistics, logistics. Get that grading plan implemented properly and that will be half the battle won. Number four, how can I check to see if that grading plan is realistic before we start? Man or woman, I'm going to give you the best advice. You have got to get in good with that civil designer. Go to their office, review with them their concerns, send them a bottle of wine for their time. Really like learn what they're worried about from a design standpoint and then add your builder knowledge with it, with the trade partners. Collaboration is key with that. You can review these plans and get ahead of it and have most of the problems solved before you ever even start on site. And then number five, this is a big topic. Who's responsible for verifying verifying accuracy on site. You've come to the wrong place if you don't want a thorough answer. I am a Hensel Phelps person at heart. Surveyors and field engineers and the crews themselves, it is your job, and it starts with the GC to verify that it's right. I'm talking verify the basis of bearings, verify all of the on site, verify your primary control, traverse it, level loop it, establish your secondary control, do as-builts of all of the existing structures on site, pothole and survey any of your points of connection for underground utilities, do an underground utility map so that you don't hit utilities on the project site, do verification of your actual underground utilities and your grading with your field engineers, have your field engineers and your surveyor double check the building pad. My answer is you, and some more you, and just a little bit more you must make sure these things are correct. In fact, oh, this is such a good video. I even have observed the most respected general and project superintendents going out there on site and laying out the building on site with the caissons and the footings and everything to measure to make sure we're within the property lines and seeing what adjustments need to be made. And I've seen multiple times, oh, that caisson is in the way of a duct bank because we did the blue stake before, or the 811, whatever you call it in your region, before we went out and laid it out. Or, hey, this is the wrong dimension. Or, hey, I need shoring here. Or, hey. It is your job to go verify these things. So let me just go ahead and say that a grading plan is your base. You need it to get your building permit. You need it to get into foundations, and it needs to be done right. Literally, the better you prepare that, the better everything else will be. And so even if you just implement the guidance that I gave you in these questions, you'll be so far ahead of your competitors. Get the base right, shape the environment, and everything else will flow. And actually, those are the two responsibilities of a general contractor. Have a great environment and keep the rhythm. I'm gonna turn this into a checklist for you on a beautifully formatted Canva graphic. Reach out to me if you ever have questions, but this is huge. It's so important. Please take this seriously. I hope you've enjoyed this video. On we go.